We blame meteorologists for a lot. They ruin camping trips, golf trips, days at the beach. Why are they always wrong? I'm gonna say something controversial here. Weather forecasting isn't bad. It's actually really accurate. Bear with me. To get a prediction on the weather, someone has to measure humidity, wind speed, rain, sun, clouds, dew point, and 100 other things all over the world. It's crazy to think about the amount of data we need just to say if it's gonna rain on Thursday. To paraphrase a famous astrophysicist, the weather is under no obligation to make sense to you. And yet we keep trying. For most of the 20th century, weather forecasting was mediocre at best, because we didn't have two things, satellites and supercomputers. Once we got those, we really knocked it out of the sunny ballpark. In 1972, we could predict temperatures in a range of plus or minus about 6 degrees, like it's gonna be in the 60s tomorrow. Now it's 2 to 3 degrees. There's a big difference between the high 60s and the low 60s when it comes to a forecast. And we get rain right about 82% of the time, which is fantastic considering we didn't even know what a cold or warm front was 100 years ago. Like I said though, satellites and supercomputers. Satellites made weather forecasting amazing. The first sat to take pictures of the clouds over the United States was Tiros 1 in April of 1960. In the first week, it spotted a typhoon, which is huge. Tropical storms, hurricanes, and typhoons were very difficult to detect before satellites. We've launched dozens of weather sats in the last 57 years, with the newest making the originals look like the Stone Age. Now we can see cloud patterns, spot tropical storms as they form, see heat maps, and even see differences between clouds, water vapor, smoke, ice, and volcanic ash. It's insane. But as we started to get more data, it started to just be too much for our puny human brains to fathom. Around the turn of the last century, numerical weather monitoring was first attempted. It applied the laws of physics to the weather and the atmosphere. Meteorologists divided the world into a grid of small imaginary boxes and calculated the weather in each box and how that would affect the box around it. And it turns out this is kind of impossible without a computer. It took a 1920s mathematician 3 months to predict 24 hours of weather. Slowly. Supercomputers, on the other hand, can run many millions of these grid calculations every second, each time they use real weather data and they create a simulation of what could happen. Humans could not do this, not even close. Daily, NOAA's supercomputer pumps enough data equal to more than twice the entire printed collection of the Library of Congress. Even still, weather models or simulations aren't perfect. There are lots of them used by different organizations all over the world, and they are always tweaking them based on new research. And yet, the supercomputer can only get us so far. Humans have to be part of this weather prediction equation. The National Weather Service says humans improve rain forecasting by 25%, because let's be clear, computers only know what we tell them. They can't infer or guess, they just calculate. And it's not like before sats and supercomputers we knew nothing, like Jon Snow. Before space travel, we used, and still use, radar, balloons, weather stations spread across the country and the ocean. And before electronics, people could look at the sky, or even read almanacs. Seriously. Red sky in the morning, sailor's warning, has to do with atmospheric thickness. Red light scatters the least, so it can make it through the thicker air of a possible storm front. Stars below a 40-degree angle twinkle normally, but stars overhead actually don't. When the higher-up stars start to twinkle, rain's a-comin'. Not to mention people kept records of weather on days of the year, and knowing the history helps us predict the future, but it's not very precise. Almanacs are actually bad weather predictors. And snow in April doesn't mean that global warming is a hoax. Weather is big and complicated and global, and to be honest, we're still figuring it out. In the end, stop raining on your local meteorologist's parade. Climate and weather are different things, by the way. I'm not even gonna touch that today. But if global warming is real, then is NASA lying? Because Antarctic ice is growing. Find out more about that in this video. Do you love your local meteorologist? Tell me your thoughts down in the comments, and take a second and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, fam. We'll see you next time on Seeker.